Vamos! Jill Teichmann might be speaking Espanol right now. Jill Teichmann takes out Nuria Diaz in straight sets. Jill Teichmann, what's going on, guys? She's like plummeting in the rankings here. She has to qualify for these slams. She's now 123 in the rankings, and I've personally stated that I think Jill Teichmann, I think she's a top 40 player. She's been as high as, you know, 20 on tour, but I think she's a top 40 player if she's playing great on clay. Clay is her strongest surface, and I'm just surprised. I mean, with so many championships that she's won on clay on the lower level, that she doesn't win. I'm just surprised she doesn't do better at these clay tournaments. I don't know what it is. And she's left-handed, she's athletic, but she said it herself, she gets a bad rap, right? She thinks that the perception of her is that people think that she's arrogant, that she's cocky. And I'll be honest with you, she gets the victory here in straight sets over Diaz. But let's talk about Jill Teichmann for a minute. She said it herself, people give her a bad rap. And I'll be honest with you, she has a swag in her step that I don't think she realizes she has. Now, just being left-handed kind of contributes to that, but she has swagger. She's got the juice. Trust me, guys, the way she walks, I don't think she realizes it. Watch her walk. Like, even when she's walking to the net after a victory or walking to her chair to get her towel, she has swag. It's natural swag. And people see that and they're like, oh, yeah, she thinks she's the shh. And she probably is, guys. I mean, she's a former junior, number three. She's won a junior slam in doubles, gold medal, mixed doubles. She has swag, guys, and she did very well on the lower level. Couple main tour championships as well. She hasn't done anything in a few years, but, you know, I do think she gets a bad rap because she's not aware of that swag, that natural swag she has, and it's easy to confuse confidence with arrogance. Confidence is experience. Confidence is success, and Jill Teichmann has it. Let's talk about Svitolina. Now, when we're talking about people that come off arrogant, I think Svitolina does. I think she's humbled herself a little more, and I don't like to use the word humble, right? That means low, bring yourself, you know, to a low vibration. You shouldn't have to humble yourself because you make someone else feel uncomfortable, you know, just being confident and successful. And I say it again, confidence is experience. Experience is confidence. So if you see someone that's confident, they know they can do something. They've done it before. They've had the results. So that's what winners do. They, you know, they give off this energy, and energy is contagious. If it's good energy, it's going to produce good results. Now, Svitolina I used to think that Svitolina was very cocky and arrogant. But again, sometimes you have to get to know people, right? The persona and the perception, it can be distorted, especially when you're dealing with athletes that have to be confident. I say it all the time. I think a lot of professionals retire, not because they can't perform anymore, but because they lose their confidence. You know, you have to understand, when you're an athlete, you're playing in different arenas, different stadiums, different countries, where a lot of times, if you're not at home, people are booing you. Right? They're hurting your confidence. They want to see their player win. So they have to put you down when you do bad and praise when they do good. So a lot of times I think professional athletes retire because they lose their confidence. You know, they're professional. They're capable of producing an average set of results that are normally desirable, right? So it's not about the ability to perform. I think it's about the confidence factor that they lose. Now, Svitolina, she's on one, guys. Now, she had words to say about to Sabalenka. You know, she said to Sabalenka, I have no idea. And of course, she said this in the press, in the media. She said, I have no idea why she was waiting at the net. I've made it clear my stance on handshakes. She is cocky, bro. She's got swagger, man. I'm telling you, I like Svitolina. I did think before, actually, you know, just watching her play more and getting to know her more from, you know, the TV level and just seeing her perform and do interviews, I used to think she was really arrogant, but it's really not the case. She comes off that way just because she's confident in her abilities, and she's a future Hall of Famer, but she is savage. And look, I'm going to bring it up again. Dejana Yastremska is savage. She's confident too. She's not shaking anyone's hands. She's not even shaking the chair umpire hands. The Ukraine, man, they got some tough cookies, but they have to be tough. It's a tough situation over there, and we send our condolences to anyone in Russia or Ukraine that's going through horrible things, that have lost family members and friends. It's a tragic situation. We want it to end. We want peace. But Jill Teichmann wins. She takes out Nuria Diaz. Nuria is a clay player primarily. We know that. But Teichmann does it impressively, winning 70% of her first serve, 70% of her second serves. She won 50% of Nuria's first and second serves. She dominated her, look, 12 breakpoint opportunities. Teichmann advances. We're going to see what she can do in grass season, guys. I'm your host, Tennis in a Minute. If you enjoy when I go off on these different topic discussions, drop a like and I'll do it more. See you soon.